How can you configure our PV point on the GEN24 Plus inverter? This is what we are going to talk about today. So first of all, for the optional backup power possibility that we have with the GEN24 Plus hybrid inverter, we have the function called PV point. The PV point now is a single phase backup power solution that you can use as an external output of the GEN24 Plus device. With the PV point, you have the possibility to have a single phase backup power, for example, for switching over your fridge or switching over other loads in the household that you want to have during grid blackouts. Yeah, the PV point is relatively easy installed. Please note, this is an extra AC output from the GEN24 Plus, and therefore you need to fuse the PV point socket with a circuit interrupter with 30 milliamps. So this is really important since the PV point has no connection to your standard household installation and therefore has no security devices on it. You can do this by either using a socket with an integrated circuit breaker, or for example, you can use this also as an external box where you just install a standard household socket together with an RCD. Yeah, on the other hand side, you can install the PV point relatively easy on the hardware side, and on the other hand side, we can activate it in the web interface, in the web UI of the inverter. So therefore, we are going to have a look on the GEN24 Plus web interface. Here we can see the web interface of the GEN24 Plus, and here on the left-hand side, you can click on the settings of the inverter. Therefore, you can go under device configuration and can log in with your technician password. Yeah, after that, you can click on the function and IOs button, and here you can find the point backup power. You can activate the backup power by just switching on here this little dip switch. And after that, you can do the configuration part. And in our case, we are choosing the PV point option. After that, you can switch a backup nominal voltage. In our case, we are choosing 230 volts. And after that, we have two more possibilities. First of all, the SOC warning level. So this comes into play when you are using a stationary PV storage. And whenever you are using a PV stationary storage, this is optional for the PV point, so you can use the PV point even without battery storage. But if you are using a battery storage in your system, you can define an SOC warning level. So this means that the customer gets a notification just before the energy of the battery storage runs out, and therefore he is notified that the backup power solution will turn off in a few minutes. Second on, you can also set the reserve capacity, and with that you can make sure that the amount of the battery storage, for example 25%, is always reserved for the backup power. So with that you can make sure that even during cold winter nights, when the public grid fails, that you have your backup power solution available. Yeah, this is more or less all that you need to configure here for the PV point, and when you are finished with the configuration, you can just hit the save button. Yeah, and after clicking the save button, you are now fully configured with the PV point and can now use the system as you want. Please note, the PV point will be always activated when the public grid fails or when the public grid is turned off, and during grid parallel times, the PV point will be deactivated. Yeah, you can always use a battery storage to this system. So if you want, you can alternatively put the battery storage to the system and use it together with a PV battery storage or even without. When you don't use a battery storage on here, you can use the PV point as long as you have sunshine on the PV generator. So I hope this short video was helpful for you and you can use the PV point in the future for your systems. See you the next time.